My name is Tim Walking Bear Goodblood. I have worked with plants and nature my whole life. I have specialized in herbalism, the teaching of it and the application of it in my life and other people's lives for the past 17 years. I work with plants, help plants communicate, and I help people to open their wild hearts and to rekindle their inherent connection to nature and the earth.
I am the Plant Whisperer.
Hello, folks. Today, I'm going to make a rather unusual medicine. And I've showed this technique to a few herbalists. And they're all quite amazed and think that this is a... And their first impression is that they think that this is a new technique, when in reality it's actually an ancient technique that's been kind of forgotten about. And me and a few other herbalists are trying to bring it back to life. And it's called a mead tincture. You'll see little pinholes inside the, what look like little pinholes in the leaf. And they're actually little pockets of chemical medicine constituent. And that's the medicine that's used internally for depression. However, in the buds, there's a different medicine. When you squeeze the bud, the red purplish dye comes out, and that is sun medicine and skin medicine. It will protect you from the sun. It's also the anti-inflammatory and anti-spasmodic and pain-relieving qualities. In traditional modern day, herbalists like to use a solution, extraction solution of 50% water and 50% alcohol. They usually use 100 proof vodka or rum to do this, or they'll use 190 proof grain alcohol and water it down to a 50-50 solution.
This part of the country in New England, the natives were known to tap at least 8 different trees in the spring and the fall for their sap, which they would boil down to make syrup and sugars. These are the sugars that they would have worked with.
Now when you take an alcohol and then you distill it, like a mead or a wine, and you distill it, you're heating it up and you're extracting the alcohol from it. This takes a lot of life out of that menstruum, that liquid. However, a mead has not gone through that process. A mead is full of yeast and enzymes and things that are alive. So this makes for a very live medicine. I do need to clarify though that these medicine mead tinctures are not an alcoholic beverage. They are not made to be consumed by the glassfuls at a party like you would wine or champagne. In fact, that could be dangerous depending on the herb that you're working with and the person's sensitivity to it that's consuming it. It's a good idea to stick to the recommended dose, because it is a medicine and not a beverage. And a recommended dose for this particular medicine is anywhere from a tablespoon to 1 cup. This is the mead that we used earlier to extract with. Now, when you look at the color and compare it to the mead that we put that we infused St. John's wort in, you can clearly see that it's a deeper red color. Now, that is the medicine constituent of the flower bud, the red oil that's within the flower bud that I showed you earlier.
I am the Plant Whisperer.